Debugging websites on Chrome for Android can be quite challenging. That is, if you don't have an Android device at hand. Or even if you do have one, you still have to connect it, set it up, and it's not really an ideal workflow. There is an easier way though, and that is using the Android emulator. In this video, I will show you how to set it up using the Android Studio and how to connect the Android Chrome to the developer tools available directly in your Chrome for desktop to debug websites. Let's jump in. Alright, as I mentioned, there are some differences between Chrome on Android and Chrome desktop, and the easiest way to find those would be to use Can I Use site. I have it right here, it's caniuse.com, link is going to be in the description. And we have this beautiful feature here called Compare Browsers, and here we can select our latest Chrome version on desktop, which is going to be 102, and latest Chrome version on mobile, which is going to be Chrome for Android 102, and this would show us exactly the differences. And as you can see, most of the features here are supported in both browsers, but there are some differences that you can see right here. For features that are not supported in both browsers, you would have to use something like an emulator to make sure that the Chrome on desktop or on Android works as you would expect, including feature detection or whatever it is you need to do. Most of the features here are something that are mainly OS related, something like a web share API that stands out, for example, which is not supported on desktop, but is supported on Chrome on Android. So if you want to test this, you would have to use something like an Android emulator. So first thing that you need to do is you have to download Android Studio, and you're going to find Android Studio at developer.android/studio. Link is going to be in the description as well. And right here you have a download Android Studio link that should automatically select the appropriate version for your current system, or you can go to the download options right here and select manually the version that you want. If you're on Windows, you're going to select one of those, on Mac this one or this one. And as well, there are options for Linux and Chrome OS. As I'm using Mac OS here, the tutorial is going to show you exactly how this works, but the Windows and Linux versions should also be pretty much similar to this one. Once you download this, you're gonna have to install it. Just double click on it, whatever you need to do, click next, next, next. I didn't do anything special, just follow the setup wizard and everything worked as expected. And once it's ready, you can open it. Let's open it right here. Android Studio. It takes a bit to open, and once it opens, you're gonna see this Welcome to Android Studio screen. As we're only gonna be using an emulator, we don't really have to create a new project. We can go directly here into More Actions, and you're gonna find the Virtual Device Manager. If you just install Android Studio, this should be empty, and you can add a new device for which you will select an appropriate Android version and appropriate device frame. So let's do that right now. Create device. And right here, you can select hardware. For this example, I'm just gonna use Pixel XL. And as you see here on the list, you can select phone, Wear OS, tablet, whatever it is you wanna test specifically. And once you select the appropriate frame with the resolution and the density that comes with it, just click next. Here you have to download the system image to be able to use the emulator with that particular version of Android. I already downloaded the S version. If you still haven't, click the download next to the version you want to download, next to the version you want to test. And once it's ready, once it's downloaded, you should see the next button enabled right here. Click next and add a name that you want, maybe the device, the API version of the Android, which will help you identify it if you have more devices, more setups on the list before. And I'm gonna just use everything as comes, click finish, and this will create our virtual device. You can run it right here, and this will then load the emulator and start the Android OS in this frame that we've selected on our list earlier. When the emulator loads, you're gonna find Chrome on the desktop right here, so click that. You can use your keyboard right here to open a website that you wanna debug. I will just open CSS Weekly to show you how it works. There we go. And right now, as the website is open, we're gonna move to the Chrome browser on our desktop. And this is going to be right here. And we're gonna enter the specific address that shows you connected devices. And we can access that if we go into Chrome Inspect Devices. And this will show you all the connected devices. Right here, you see our remote target with the SDK we started. And this is our website we opened on our emulator. We can use inspect element right here. Let me move this window to the right. This will open our Chrome DevTools with the preview of our website as shown in the emulator. So let's open emulator again. And here it is. So if you scroll on Android, you're gonna see that all changes are automatically immediately reflected. So this is connected, it's live. You can work on it as you would expect. For example, if you wanna change the background of our body, to red, you're gonna see that it takes effect both in our emulator right here and also in our DevTools preview right here, so it can work exactly as you would expect. And to demonstrate the actual difference, we're gonna open a demo with the WebShare API, which is not supported on desktop, but it is supported in Android. Link to this demo is going to be in the description if you wanna check it out yourself. If we try to initiate the share dialog on our Chrome desktop right here, we can click here. This feature is not supported on Chrome desktop, but at the same time, you can see that on our actual device, on our Android emulator, this share dialog appeared immediately, which means that it actually works. And there is a difference between Chrome desktop and Chrome mobile. Some features aren't supported, and if you want to test those features, use the Android emulator. You can use different versions, different frames. It's pretty simple to use it, and as you can connect it directly to the Chrome DevTools, it's very nice experience to debug mobile specific things directly in your Chrome developer tools. I hope you found this helpful. I hope this helps you debug Android devices, even if you don't own an actual device, or even if you just don't want to connect a device to your computer. You can really quickly see what the difference is between the desktop Chrome and the Android Chrome. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in the next emulator, or rather in the next video.